This is Kurt Heisinger, accounting professor at Sierra College and author of Managerial Accounting. This video summarizes the performance measures that can be used for an investment center. And an investment center is a division or a particular segment of a company that is responsible for long-term investments in assets, for the profits of the company, meaning the revenues and the costs associated with, I should say, the division or the segment. And the performance measures that you see here are often used to evaluate the performance of an investment center. I've created many different videos that are related to these performance measures that provide the details of calculating these performance measures, and they all use the same company, and this is the one that you see here, Game Products, Inc. They all use the same exact information that you see here, meaning they use the same revenues, the same income, the same assets, operating assets, all the different measures that are required, all the different components that are required to put together the calculations to get the measures that you see here. So please take a look at those videos if you want to see where these numbers come from. This is simply a summary of all that information. So our company is Game Products, Inc., and we have three different divisions. We have the sporting goods division, we have a board games division, and we have a computer games division. Each of these divisions is considered an investment center, and these are the resulting calculations related to each of these divisions. And I have a video for finding segmented net income, and that same video shows the profit margin ratio. I also have a video showing how to calculate the return on investment, how to calculate residual income, and how to calculate economic value added. And what you see here then is a culmination of all of that information and all of those videos. The measures that you see here are here to evaluate each of these divisions. And as we move our way down, you'll see that they get a little more complicated if you go back to those videos to see how these calculations are done. So what you see here then is that we've got segmented net income for the sporting goods division of, these are all in thousands, of $2,306,000. They had a profit margin ratio of 11.53%, a return on investment, which then starts to incorporate the assets that were required to produce that income, of 11.23%, and residual income of $947,000. And economic value added of $478,000. And this is done for each division. What I'll show you then on the next two slides are the graphs that summarize this information. So this graph shows the measures that are included in dollars, that are stated, I should say, in dollars. And the next graph shows the measures that are stated in percentage form. And what you see here then is sporting goods is the first item you see on this graph. They had segmented net income of $2,306,000. Board games is next at $3,466,000, and computer games is next at $1,577,000. And each of these bars then represents a division within the company, or a subunit within the same company. So we've got the sporting goods division, the board games division, and the computer games division, and we're looking at the results for each of them. Residual income is the next graph that you see here, right? This one right here. And this shows that sporting goods and board games were positive in terms of residual income, and the computer games is negative in terms of residual income for the year that we are looking at. And finally, we have economic value over here at the far right. And you'll see here that sporting goods has a positive economic value added dollar amount, as does the board games, and computer games happens to be the highest using economic value added. So again, if you want to find out why that's the case, go back and take a look at the separate video that talks about economic value added and how to calculate it. These two sets of graphs show the profit margin ratio and the return on investment for each division. And you'll notice that the first graph is for the profit margin ratio. You'll notice here that the sporting goods division has a profit margin ratio of 11.53%, and board games is 10.19%, and the computer games division has a profit margin ratio of 5.44%. Remember that these ratios do not include assets at all. So all we're looking at is what their profit is as a percentage of their sales. Then we go over to the far right, and look at the and where you can see the return on investment ratios, and you'll see here that sporting goods has 11.23% as their ROI, which is what it's often called. The board games division has an ROI of 8.93%, and computer games has an ROI of 6.75%. So it looks like in both measures that sporting goods, the sporting goods division, is performing the best. Please take a look at the detailed calculations. I have a separate video for the profit margin ratio and a separate video on how to calculate the return on investment ratio to see where these numbers come from.